Round 4, Surface Paradise. Shannon Eckstein, a local and a hero. No surprise he won the Eliminator. His rivals call him a freak, and this is why.
Shannon Eckstein is turning on the turbos here.
That was awesome.
And who's this? A new face out front. 31-year-old Rebecca Creedy ending the winning run of Liz Plumer's.
Rebecca Creedy! And take the tape! Absolutely wonderful!
Round 5 today's in Newcastle. Iron Man action, a perfect fit in the city built on steel. But who will break free and pump the fist? This is the Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Iron Man Series, and the championship is up for grabs.
Just 1.5 hours drive north of Sydney is where you'll find Newcastle, the steel city sitting on the coastline, with beaches known for dishing up great surf and a bit of drama as well. Welcome to round 5 of the Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Iron Man and Woman Series. I'm Ashlyn Krukellis, and we are nearing the pointy end of the season. We have another exciting day of racing ahead, and joining me to dissect every crucial moment of the action is our expert commentator, former Iron Man, Rhys Drury. Rhys, welcome to Newcastle Beach, and what a day we have ahead. We have Shannon Eckstein gunning for his 9th series victory, but plenty of guys want to disrupt that dream, and they're capable of doing it too.
Absolutely. Wow, what a series we've had so far. We've got Ali Day, the comeback kid. He's still leading the series. Then we've got Kai Hurst, the veteran, hanging in there. We've got a number of other guys that still can win this title. The series is wide open. It's been so exciting, and today's racing, it's going to be cracking out there.
Yeah, well, let's have a look at just how tight this series is. Shannon Eckstein, the defending champ, he's in second position, only 2 points behind our leader, Ali Day. Kai Hurst, Matt Poole, Kendrick Louie, Wesberg, all these guys are bunched together. They all have the chance of winning if things go their way.
As we look over the page in number 9, there's Tannen Linden, the smiling assassin. He's gunning for this 8th position, which gives you an automatic qualifier for next year. So he'll be really putting the pressure on young Luke Cup. Nathan Smith, the veteran, sitting in number 10. And then we go down, look at Kane Eckstein, who's in an unfamiliar position after some bad luck this year and injuries. And rounding out the top 15, Sam Hamilton.
Newcastle Beach, of course, has some pretty special memories, doesn't it? It's where we saw Shannon Eckstein crowned series champion for the 8th time last year. It's also where we saw some controversy last year.
Absolutely. We saw Matty Poole drop the shoulder into Shannon Eckstein and send him flying to the sand. So Matty went on to win the round, win the race, but it caused a lot of controversy. There was appeals, there was friction on the beach, and it left a lot of bad blood on that day. So it'd be interesting to see how things pan out today, to see how the guys react to that. But last year, it was heavy. It was a heavy day.
It was an unforgettable day for sure. So we decided to catch up with both Matt Poole and Shannon Eckstein to see how they're feeling about things now that a year has passed.
Now Shannon's gone across in front of him. This is on!
That race, I was just so fired up.
Oh, what a finish it is here!
I wanted the win, I wanted it really bad.
It's Eckstein in front, Poole just behind him.
If you get to that turn first, it's pretty hard to get beaten.
They come around this final turn!
Pretty hard to get beaten unless you get pushed over.
Oh, what's happened there? He's bumped him out of the way. Poole's got across, Eckstein's in the sand.
I felt something in my back.
Before he went down the straight, my knees hit the back of his leg.
What a race. Oh. I can't believe it's finished like that.
I didn't like to see Shannon hit the sand. That wasn't really the way I pictured the finish, but at the end of the day, I thought I was going to win the race, and I wanted it bad enough.
Obviously, I wasn't happy at the time.
Here's Shannon sitting on the beach. He's asking, did he push me?
You know, my decision is that the placings stand as they are.
I don't want nippers running around and doing that in the sport. And I said that, and they didn't agree with me, and I moved on with it.
I didn't like the sort of the vibe on the beach that came off it. You know, I've always been a hard racer, but I've always been a fair racer.
You know, if that incident happened again, I don't think you'd get away with it again. I think things have changed. People have spoken up.
Bang, there's the knee. Shannon goes forward, Pooley goes forward, and Shannon goes down.
I'd say if he had his time again, he'd probably do things differently.
Hindsight on my side, I don't think I have to change anything. Everything got reviewed, everything got looked at, and I won, so.
You know, it's not something I worry about. It's not going to define my career.
Can't wait to see what happens today. Well, when we have a look at the women's series, Liz Plumas certainly has been the standout, winning 3 of the 4 rounds. Reese, this has really been her year.
Liz Plumas, she's had a great year this year. She's fit, fast and focused. She's the ultimate professional. But we did see a bit of a chink in her armour. She didn't win last round. Beck Creedy got the win on her. So it'll be interesting to see how she reacts, but she's definitely having a fantastic year.
Yeah, she does have athletes breathing down her neck, doesn't she? Rebecca Creedy being one of them. Another one being Harriet Brown. She's not too far behind.
Yeah, Harriet Brown, what a great year she's having. I'm really happy for Harriet because she's been consistent. She's been qualifying over the last few years. But this year, she's finishing on the podium and really putting pressure on the top girls. So she's obviously had a great off-season. She's looking really focused. And it'll be interesting to see how she races today. I think she'll do really well.
Yeah, let's hope so. Well, let's have a look at where the series point stands after 4 rounds for our women. Liz Plumas, as we said, right out in front. She's got a 10-point lead on Rebecca Creedy. Harriet Brown hanging in there on 58 points in third place. Geordie Mercer isn't too far behind. Maddie Dunn, she had a great round in round 3, a second place there. That was an endurance kind of race, so we might see a strong performance from her today. Courtney Hancock, the defending champ, there in 6th.
Okay, as we look over the page, there's Tara Coleman in number 9. She'll be trying to put pressure on those girls in front of her to try and sneak into that top 8 to re-qualify for next year. Crystal Smith in number 10, the veteran, she'll want a better race today. She's not having the best season. She'll be trying to crawl her way back onto that podium. Tian Raymond, the girl from Mooloolaba, sitting in number 12. And then rounding out our top 15 is Hannah Minogue.
Well, joining us now is Rebecca Creedy, fresh from that victory in round 4. Beck, congratulations once again. You said on the finish line yourself, it's been a long time coming, so it must have been a very special moment.
Absolutely. I've been in the series 7 years now and haven't really spent a lot of time on the podium and had a few already this year. And to finally get on top, it gives me a lot of confidence coming into round 5.
Yeah, Beck, you've been consistent over the last few years and you've had some good races, but this year you're a title contender. What's been the difference?
Yeah, look, last year I had a lot of interruptions in my preparation. I changed clubs, I moved from the Sunshine Coast down to the Gold Coast and only had about 5 weeks preparation before the series, whereas this year I've done the Coolangatta Gold and really focused on the little things and getting my skills right. And, you know, it's just made all the difference of coming confident and ready to race and excited to race.
We have a long race today with the M-shape format. What's your strategy heading into this one?
Yeah, just again, concentrating on the little things. We're crossing that brake zone 8 times today, and it's those little things that make the difference. Holding my ski all the way to the beach, catching that critical runner on the board, and getting that swim wave. All it takes is one slip up, and you can be behind the 8 ball.
Well, we wish you all the best today, Beck. And another athlete, of course, who will be hoping for a strong finish to this series is Courtney Hancock. She's currently sitting in 6th position, but she's not satisfied there. She is the defending champ and a 3-time series winner. Let's learn a bit more about Courtney Hancock.
I remember finishing when I won the first Nutri-Grain Ironman series. Oh my God, I won! Like it was so such a surreal moment for me, and I was very, very proud and very happy, and it made me want more. I think every year there's something different that motivates you. And for me at the moment, it's pushing myself to the limits. And that's why I'm an athlete, because I have that inside me. I have that fire, I have that drive, and I have those goals and I really want to achieve them, because at the end of the day, I'm that kind of person. I want to keep grabbing on and getting more and getting more. And that's my personality. I have that drive. So definitely the swim leg would have to be my strongest. That's always been my weapon as an Ironwoman, and I just really feel that water. I have this real connection, I guess, with the water and the way I pull through. I'm racing out there, I completely have no worries in the world, and that's why I think being an athlete comes so naturally to me. As soon as I get my foot on the line, that's what I'm aiming for. I'm aiming for that number one spot, and I'd be most disappointed if I finished a race. I thought to myself, I could have given that more. So that's when I've achieved the most, is when I get out there and I've given absolutely everything.
To Newcastle Beach. It is a simply stunning day here today, and plenty of people are coming down to make the most of the sunshine and cool off in the water. There's not a cloud in the sky, and as we have a look at the official forecast, it looks like things are going to stay pretty nice. We're expecting a mostly sunny day with a top of 27 degrees, 21 in the water. We're expecting waves half a metre to a metre. Winds are coming from the northeast, and they're actually expected to pick up throughout the day, reaching 15 to 20 knots this afternoon. Well, our Iron Women are ready to race. So let's head up to the commentary box. Your commentators are Trevor Hendy, Rhys Drury and Tim Gilbert.
Yeah, crystal clear day, Ashlyn, and great to see you again. And what a day we have ahead of us here. Courtney Hancock, Liz Plumers, Crystal Smith, Maddie Dunn, Rebecca Creedy, Amy Nerthen, Harriet Brown. She's had a really good series, Harriet, hasn't she? Devon Halligan there. Jordan Mercer also doing good things this year. Tara Coleman, Hannah Minogue, Tian Raymond. There they are on the line. These are our 15 competitors. It has been owned by Liz Plumers so far, but in the last race, we saw Rebecca Creedy pop her head up and have a great win. But that all changes today. Two rounds to go. Newcastle, round five and round six on a belter of a day. This is the M-shaped swim ski board. And we are underway at Newcastle. Can Liz Plumers just cruise her way to victory here? There'll be plenty of others trying to stop her.
Of course, and what a tough day of racing this is going to be. It's crystal clear water, it's hot on the beach, it's a small shore break that's going to make more of a difference on the way in, I think, than on the way out. But already we're going to see the girls heading a little bit to the left to try and get that little bit of run. It's a famous Newcastle rip right next to the rock.
Really clear water, Trevor, too. Obviously, with this, a lot of the girls will be wearing goggles. And underneath the water, you can see where all your athletes are.
All righty, the girls are getting out there, the swim leg in the M shape. But the course map, well, this isn't an easy format, is it, Trevor, as we have a look at the course map right now?
Of our three courses, this is the M shape. We've visited this twice this season and very, very challenging. We start off with our swim. Out and back in gives a couple of chances to make a mistake or make a break. We repeat that with the ski in the M, also with the board, obviously the board. Back to the beach, run each time. They repeat that whole thing twice.
Interesting to hear from Courtney Hancock in the earlier part of the program. And she was saying how she's an athlete, how she wants to be at the pointy end. It hasn't happened for her here. She has a way now. She can't win the series, but she has a way of getting back up and showing everyone how good she is. Right at the moment, it's Emma Dick who's out in front, and Brodie Moyer just behind her. They're all searching for this first wave, guys.
And here it is. Look at this wave. A few of the girls. Great surfing there.
Emma Dick had to stand up and wait for it, and she's done a great job to join the wave as well. That's five of the girls. They'll be very happy with that.
Yeah, it looks like Liz on the left. Brodie, of course, is in there, and Emma right out in front. She waited for the rest of them, didn't they?
And she's going to hold it through. Look at this. Beautiful body surfing. Head down. Fingers right to the water's edge. Emma Dick.
Awesome surfing.
Yeah, so well done, Emma Dick. She's first up onto the beach. Remember, this is the M format. We see Liz come past. There's Brodie. Amy Nerthen is there as well.
And that was Tara Coleman that dropped off the wave just at the finish there.
And this is where it gets a little bit tough now. First swim, adrenaline's starting to settle in. They've got to push through this inside shore and get back into the swing of things as we see Tian Raymond run around.
Yeah, a little bit of catching up to do, and Jordan Mercer looks out to sea a little bit bewildered. She said in an interview in the last round that she wants to improve this swim leg, and she won't be happy with the way that this has started for her.
Particularly not with swim first. Sometimes when you're not a great swimmer, it's harder in the latter part of it to actually hang in there because people, you know, you're a bit tired, your stroke deficiencies start to show themselves. And we look back at this wave, and here's the four. There's Emma Dick standing up and jumping on, And what a great job. The girls have got their head up. Make no mistake, they've still got to get their heads down at the right time. You'll see Brody Moyer there, and head down, away she goes.
Yeah, great pitches, absolutely wonderful pitches. And we had a wave just behind it. Ashlyn is on the beach, and Ashlyn has Zane with her.
I'm on the beach with race director Zane Holmes. Zane, the winds are expected to pick up today, but it's still pretty still at the moment. What do you make of the conditions out there?
Look, we've actually got, you know, really idyllic conditions here this morning. You know, a little wave running through. We obviously would like more swell, but, you know, there's enough there to really, you know, shake things up a little bit. But it's extremely hot, so the girls are really going to have to keep really well hydrated today, you know, to make sure that, you know, they keep in top form.
They're out there on the swim leg at the moment. It's early days, but do you have a pick?
Look, it's so hard to pick at this stage of the race. You know, they're in the first leg of six, so I'm not going to say, you know, in case I'm way off the ball, but, you know, they're certainly setting a hot pace, that's for sure.
Zane, thank you.
Thank you.
Emma Dick out in front and Brody Moyer right up there as well. And interesting, they are both on that cutoff zone, aren't they? These two rounds are so important because if you're in the top eight, you automatically qualify for next year. Otherwise, it's a grueling way through as we see the end of the swim here. All they coming in, trying to catch a wave at the back there.
Here's another wave. Look how many girls are going to get on this.
Oh, look at them go. Wow.
Emma Dick again, having to stand up and catch that wave broken. She's done that again. Really, really great surfing from Emma Dick and all the girls. That was awesome.
Yeah, brilliant stuff. It was quite a sizable one there and a number of them getting on.
Courtney Emma Hancock's come through there too.
Yeah, Courtney's done. She's got a great swim leg and she mentioned that too, didn't she? So we watched them come through. Emma Dick leads the way. And Brody's not far behind her. There's Courtney. Crystal Smith doing a lot better here. Had a disappointing Nutri-Grain Iron Woman series so far. Maddie Dunn in fifth. Tara Coleman's there. So is Harriet Brown again performing well as we see Maddie pick up a ski. And she'll want to try and improve from where she is. She's fifth at the moment, but she's been right up there right throughout the last few weeks.
And what a wonderful job she's done of picking up a ski and getting away, and that's going to be a vital part of today's racing.
So they start on the ski now, but let's have a look where they were placed after the swim. Emma Dick, then it was Moyer, Hancock, Smith and Dunn. Tara Coleman did well. Harriet Brown, Rebecca Creedy, Liz Plumers and Devon Halligan make up our top 10 after the swim. Wild World of Sports, stick around. Plenty more to come. Great to have your company, Channel 9's Wide World of Sports. And isn't that a nice picture? The girls on the ski.
And that's the whole field right there. As we see them coming to the cans, it's going to be a major part of the race to get good turns around. Look, it's already tightening up. The girls coming together, clutch your paddle.
Oh, look at this.
Tara Coleman.
Wow, Beck Creedy's coming around the outside. She's definitely playing it a lot tougher this year.
And she said she wanted to. Rebecca Creedy, Maddie Dunn. Oh, she's going to cop the paddle in the lap. And that was very close.
Oh, she's copped the paddle in the elbow too. The front of the ski just got Tara Coleman in the elbow and that would have hurt.
This is tough stuff. This is the Iron Woman series for Nutri-Grain and it is the business end. There's Liz Prumers on board. Let's have a listen to Liz.
Racing-wise, the best feeling is definitely crossing that finish line in front. You love that feeling. You know all the hard work's paid off and you're putting it all together on the day. In regards to catching waves and in the surf, the best feeling is catching a wave on a ski and holding it straight. So it's a tough skill to do and people make it look easy, but it isn't at all. And so that's really good feeling when you know you've done it well.
Yeah, well, you've done it well, as are Brody Moyer and Emma Dick. Brody on the right, Emma on the left there, and holding the balance isn't easy, but they're out in front, these two.
That was a great job actually coming in, and Liz had just talked about holding the ski straight. Even in small days like this, it's very hard. The girls did a good job.
And now they've got to do it all again here, Reese. They've got to get on the ski and go. This is Brody and Emma.
And Brody hopped on beautifully. Emma Dick just struggling. Oh, just a little, that's crucial. You have to get on clean. Look at the distance now. Brody Moyer is gone through the shorey. Emma Dick has lost like 10 metres just right there. It is so crucial to get on your ski clean and get that rate up and get going.
Yeah, there you see Maddie, Tara and Courtney now making her way in. Trevor, what about Brodie Moir? There we see her out in front on the red ski. We've seen her have some good starts, but then fade away. She even sort of said in the interview, I'm happy with sixth. The girls tend to run over the top of me. What are your thoughts?
As we see Emma Dick getting a little bit caught up and run over the top there now. Yeah, Brodie Moir, look, she was absolutely killer out there a couple of seasons ago. Had an ordinary season last season and struggling a little bit mentally with something she was struggling with 4 or 5 years ago and not quite going on with it. We see this replay here. And this is a great shot. Amy Northern leaning back.
Amy. Look at the ones behind her.
Oh, it looks so small, but this is going to make a big difference today.
Amy Northern, and we're moving on. That's Devon Halligan.
Punching through this wave. She'll lean back, just copping that on the lap. Again, but good balance there. Punch through it.
Really, really difficult stuff this is, isn't it?
And here we go. Coleman. Tara Coleman, the final one there in that shot. And watch the wave as it comes over. Hits that bank.
Rolls her off.
Gone.
Went to black. Tara Coleman, it's a tough sport, it's a difficult balance. We heard in Liz's interview how difficult it is. But Brodie Moir, can she get over that mental barrier? Liz Plumas now, of course, has dominated the series, currently in third position.
We've talked about a couple of rounds this year when the wave comes up, it hits you in the chest and it stops you in your tracks. And imagine running along, someone stops you just when you got your stride going. It's very, very hard. And that's what makes it mentally challenging as well as physically challenging.
See Brodie Moir there, she literally just stopped paddling. Arms went down and she waited for this wave, just trying to get that heart rate down, conserve a little bit of energy as we see the girls pushing on to get some waves out the back, but Brodie will get that first little sneaker.
And Emma Dick missed that wave. She would have got that with a little bit more experience. She would have known, now's my time to put in 3 or 4 hard strokes. Look, stuck in no
There's
ladies.
There's Plumas, sideways.
Oh, Liz, look at her, hanging on for dear life. She's off.
Body surfed.
What about that?
That's Trevor Hendy like that.
Oh, she's lost nothing.
Liz Plumas, someone else, go grab my ski, go grab my paddle. I'm up the beach, Liz Plumas. Look at it again in replay.
She's thrown the leg over, which is obviously not a good move in the end of it, but watch how she recovers. She's going sideways, and here we see it. She's spinning this way, and she goes over, uses the ski, pushes off her butt, and gets that body surf. And she's recovered. There she is. She's done great.
Yeah, Liz Plumas, superb pitches. That's why she is an out-and-out champion. We're on board with Harriet here. That really smooth style of Harriet on the yellow board.
Yeah, wonderful technique and tall girl. Look at this current moving around to the left.
So after the ski the first time, Brodie Moir, then we have Harriet Brown, Emma Dick, Amy Northern, Liz Plumas, Smith, Coleman, Mercer, Dunn and Minogue. So that's after the ski the first time. We're in the M format. Remember, we do them all twice. Oh, look at those.
Phew.
Hard stuff crashing out.
This is all this water moving around. The current's going across to the left. It's going sideways across the waves and it's making it difficult.
And here we are on board with Rebecca Creedy. She's coming up to a wave. She's trying to pop back. You can see the look on the face. She's so frustrated. She's battling those skills again. Look at that face. She's disappointed. You got to get back on, Beck. Get going.
Yeah, Rooster one day, feather duster the next. She won the last round, didn't she, Beck? But there's a long way to go here. Rebecca Creedy, a mighty, mighty athlete, outstanding on the Gold Coast. Let's get down to Ashlyn. Ashlyn has someone with her on the beach.
I'm on the beach with Tannen Linden, who'll of course be racing in the Ironman race a little bit later today. Tannen, you're in 9th position at the moment. Of course, it must be really important to you to get up into that top 8 and qualify for next season.
Yeah, you know, definitely. It's definitely on my mind. But, you know, coming into race time, it's sort of, you know, instead of focusing on where you are and what you're coming, sort of just try and be up in that top group and, you know, try and get it on the podium. That's the ultimate goal.
We're watching the girls out there at the moment. Brodie Moir's got quite a lead as we sort of move towards the halfway mark. Do you reckon she'll hold on?
Yeah, you know, it's a long race today, but, you know, had a brilliant start with Emma Dick and, you know, they're hanging on tight. So, you know, there's still a little way to go and it's quite hot today. So, you know, they've got a bit of work to do.
It certainly is hot. Good luck out there, Tannen.
Thank you. Cheers.
He'll have some work to do a little later on, Trev. Tannen Linden as Brodie Moir looks over his shoulder out in front.
Yeah, Tannen, one of the young stars of our sport, got a bit of a target on his back now. He's pre-qualified. But look out for him in the last couple of rounds. He's getting more experience and he'll learn from this season.
Okay, so Brodie's out there in front. These other two, that's Liz Plumas and Harriet Brown. They've got on board this wave and Brodie's just looking over the shoulder. And there's another wave for me.
Another wave.
Jordan Mercer through the middle.
Oh, that's a great one. Maddie Dunn, she's just dropped off the back. But Emma Dick, Amy Nerth and Jordan Merce with a nice wave. Brody still out in front, though.
Isn't this good to see Brody out there going for it? Harriet Brown is having a great season, and Liz Plume has come through hot on her heels. And here comes our third pack. Jordan Mercer, Amy Nerthen.
And Emma Dick is there as well. Emma's still up near the front, but it is Brody Moyer. Can she stay there? That's her challenge right at the minute. She's got Liz Plumers, who is such a technician. Here's Jordan Mercer on that wave again. Great pick.
Look at Jordan Mercer. She slides back on her knees. Courtney Hancock drops off the back. Here's Emma Dick. Amy Nerthen. They lay back, grab onto those back handles. Manny Dunn missing that wave. That is awesome. The girls keeping the nose of the board up. Great surfing.
Yeah, and here it is, Liz Plumers carving into the lead, and I think she's just about to take in front of Brody. Brody off to another great lead, and let's hope she can stay there or thereabouts and have a reasonable finish in this one.
I'm just so impressed with Harriet Brown this year. She's doing such a good job, and we've always known she's had this in her. She's got that long, slender stroke and everything else, and she's got the strength, and she's sitting right there in that lead pack as well.
Amy Nerthen's having a great race. She hasn't had the best season so far, but she's up in the top four, paddling her board really well. But look at these girls just trying to get as much out of the ocean as they can.
So there's Harriet, there is Liz, and there is Brody Moyer. Now, Brody needs to hang on with Harriet and Liz. Liz just looks brilliant, doesn't she, at the moment? She looks like she is doing it with ease.
And it looks so simple there, you know. You just paddle through, but all these washes affect each other. And they've paddled, they could stand up and run right now. That's how far they've had to paddle. No waves for these three.
So it's Elizabeth Plumers, the girl from country Queensland, first up onto the beach, and Harriet now takes in front of Brody. So it's Liz, then Harriet, then Brody Moyer. And it's a warm day in Newcastle, 27, 28 degrees. We're in the M format, so that is the first process done. Ski, board and swim. Liz Plumers, Harriet Brown, Brody Moyer, Jordan Mercer, Amy Nerthen. This is after the first board. Maddie Dunn, Courtney Hancock, Emma Dick, Tara Coleman, Rebecca Creedy. Let's do it all again. The Nutri-Grain Iron Women's Series. We've got stacks more to come from Newcastle after this. Thanks for your company, Wide World of Sports. Newcastle, just a couple of hours north of Sydney. This is the Nutri-Grain Iron Woman Series, and Liz Plumers again doing absolutely brilliantly, and she's first out in the swim. Just behind her, right on her tail, Harriet Brown, who's having a fantastic series.
Hot on her heels and doing a really, really good job. And Liz Plumers has just been almost superwoman this year. The way she's dealt with the ins and outs, the ups and downs of the series, she's been almost unstoppable, except for Beck Creedy, who's just come through from about 10th into third spot in that swim. What a swim.
Yeah, there's Courtney as well. Courtney's done well. And Maddie Dunn, of course. Brody Moyer slipped back just a little bit, but Rebecca now goes to grab her ski. Let's have a look at how we're placed. So we've had the full swim ski board, and then we've had the swim. So we have the ski and the board to go in this M format. And the placings, oh, as Liz and Harriet go over that wave. The placings are Liz Plumers, Harriet Brown, Rebecca Creedy, Courtney Hancock, Maddie Dunn. And in sixth position right at the moment is Brody. She slipped down to sixth. Amy Nerthen, Jordan Mercer, Crystal Smith and Tara Coleman. That's our top 10.
Wow, look at these waves that the girls are punching through on their ski. That's quite heavy as Amy Nerthen just punches over one there. Jordan Mercer through that as well. But there we are, Liz Plumers out in front as usual and looking really, really good. She's great technique as we're on board here with Liz. She's got a great technique early on. She's coming up to that first wave. Over she goes.
And what? Oh, Harriet just behind her. And goodness gracious me, talk about perpendicular. Yeah, Liz Plumers, look, she balances such a life too, doesn't she? Studies, she trains, she works, and she's just been a cut above the rest here. Fresh air behind her at the moment.
I was just thinking the same thing, the different stories for the different people. We even just saw it then. Liz cleanly gets over the wave, and then Harriet flies up through the air. This is what Ironwoman racing is all about, is how you deal with your set of circumstances that happen around you. And as you say, Liz's life circumstances, she juggles a lot, and it's incredible. Sometimes they say if you want a job done, you give it to a busy person. You know, if you want someone to do very well, make them busy all the time. And Liz Plumas is that, studying, working, and training to be the best Ironwoman in the world.
Yeah, 20-year-old Maddie Dunn, we're on board with that purple ski. She's doing well, isn't she, Maddie? She's been up near the front the whole time, so you can see these young athletes coming through. But right at the moment, she's not that old herself, just 26, Liz Plumas. A busy, busy life, as Trev mentioned. Came second last year after having a sabbatical for a year. And let's look at this wave at the back. Whoa. One in between, and Courtney's trying to hang on. Maddie's trying to hang on. Brody in the middle.
That's a great wave. Now, the crucial part here, they have to hold that ski straight. So we're here with... There you're going.
Harriet's just hit Liz in the head with the ski. I don't think that was on purpose.
The only way to stop her. Only way to stop her at the moment.
And that won't even stop her. She is unstoppable.
And there she is, Liz, out first. But we've had a fall. I think that's Jordan Mercer off the ski.
Yeah.
It's going sideways.
Oh, she won't be liking that. And Darren Mercer, her father and handler, will be running down on the water's edge to, you know, he can't pick it up and help her. He's just thinking, oh, Geordie, you know. But Geordie's improved a lot. He's got fantastic skills, unusual for her, to see her do that.
All right, we're out with Liz and we're out with Harriet. And just behind them is Rebecca Creedy. You mentioned the skills, Trev, how much she wants to work at them. And she's doing well here.
I just saw the look on her face when Reese was talking before, and when she fumbled on the board, had the look on her face, she was devastated with herself. Tells me two things. She hasn't let it go, the bad skills thing, but also that she really wants to change it.
On board with Liz again, and she's on the ski. She's leading the way here, leans back through, and just crashes through, doesn't she?
Force of that pushes the camera forward. Let me tell you, these waves have got a little bit of power on the
edge. Amy Nerthen, this one, and Maddie Dunn just to her side, Courtney the other side.
Punching through. They've got a lot of power, these little shorties at Newcastle. Girls are doing really well to stay on their skis and keeping that rate.
Different ski there too, cut through a little bit better, you know, actually slice through rather than punch straight in. So these are all things you have to think about when you're Ironwoman and men racing.
Oh, and look at Liz just cruise through. Their body must be hurting at the moment. We are in the M format, as we've mentioned a number of times, and they have the ski, then the board to go. What's going through the system at the moment, Trev, as we see Liz powering away just ahead of Harriet?
Yeah, I was just thinking what's going through the system, but also what's going through the mind. You know, they're really hurting at this stage. Right now, we're in that second half.
Here we go.
You're also at a part of the series when points are so, so important.
Harriet trying to get on, as is Rebecca, and they do it.
Let's see the skills of Rebecca Creedy. She's holding it straight. Oh, she's just slewed a little bit. And that's so close to holding it, but that's the difference that she's still working on. If she hangs around for another year or two, she'll get it.
She ended up pulling it around, which is great surfing there. Rebecca Creedy, she's getting the hang of things, that's for sure.
There well you done, go. Hangs around for another minute. She'll get it. She's got it already.
And well great done. Determination, great strength from her as well, as we see Liz come through, just the board to go. Harriet. Ooh, Harriet Brown.
This is our big three right now this season, isn't it? Courtney's faded back a bit. Crystal Smith's not really there at the moment. And these three girls, Harriet Brown, Liz Plumas and Rebecca Creedy, keep turning up in that top three.
Just eight.
Incredible.
Just 880 metres to go. That's after the second ski. Liz, Harriet, Rebecca Creedy, Amy Nerthen, Brody Moyer, Maddie Dunn, Crystal Smith, Jordan Mercer and Tara Coleman are our top ten right at the minute. Courtney Hancock in fifth.
Again, the girls are faced with this Newcastle shore, and bang, they punch through it. Harriet Brown, a little slip there, and that'll cost her a few metres. She needs to get back on and punch through this wave. Here we are on board with her. She's coming up to it. Do I roll? Do I pop? Tries to punch over it and slips off, but she holds onto her board. Crucial, you can't lose your gear. Get back on and go.
Yeah, 24-year-old Harriet Brown from the Ocean Grove in Victoria South, and really making a name. 2014 Australian Ironwoman runner-up, 2014 World Board Champion, and Courtney Hancock, of course, our reigning champion. She's going to lose it this time, but she's currently in fifth.
Courtney and Harriet, actually training partners at Northcliffe. coming from different regions of the country, but actually ending up together, one from the mid-North Coast of New South Wales and one from Torquay, and ending up together at Northcliffe, but really support each other. Harriet's super, super popular amongst the sport. Lovely, lovely girl, and everyone's loving seeing her do well.
Yeah, and Rebecca Creedy equally as popular. Someone that changed disciplines, 31 years of age, been doing it 7 years, notched her first win in the last round. But Liz Plumers, she's the superstar at the minute.
I was just looking at Harriet Brown and we got the shot to see it. Look at the mouth gasping to get the breath back over those after that wave knocked her back, and she's worked hard to get back there. Make no mistake, these girls' heart rate are up around 180 right now.
It's a real ding-dong battle for second here, isn't it? Harriet and Rebecca.
And look at, here we are, Harriet trying to put great board paddling to get onto that wave. She's brought it back up to Liz Plumers.
Down they come.
And again, look at these waves out the back, Beck Creedy. Courtney Hancock on that next wave. The girls, great surfing. Amy Nerfen sitting out the back waiting for one.
Yeah, and here she comes, Amy. She's cruising down the face of that wave. And Brodie Moyer just next to her. So this is a tight old battle, this. We've got Harriet Brown and Liz out in front, then a real go for second with Rebecca Creedy trying to catch him and Courtney Hancock.
Wow, once again, they come back in, jump in. They've got to get across this little bit of gutter and then the sandbank. Brodie Moyer still hanging in there and doing a pretty good job, but did drop back a little bit in this last couple of legs.
Yep, so it's Liz out in front and Harriet at the top of the board flying up again.
Super impressed with all these girls at the speed of this race. I can't believe the rate they're going as a few of the girls punching through this shore again. But Liz is looking really comfortable out in front. A few of the girls, here comes roll time under that, holding onto the straps. Whoa!
Maddie Dunn gets knocked off to the right there.
She's got some power.
Smashed, and Amy Nerfen just slips back up onto the board. She got crushed in that as well. The girls out in front, the four of them, just managed to escape it. Rebecca Creedy, let's have a look.
Oh, and look, she just gets over nice and clean. And what's good for one girl is actually wiping out the next. So that wave was what wiped the girls out. We come back, we see Amy Nerfen, Brodie Moyer, under to the right, on their head and drags them back. Look how clear that is. We've seen the carnage from underneath.
Every moment counts. This is the final leg of this as Courtney Hancock comes around the Cairns, just cruises around the Cairns. None of that sort of real fight that we've seen in the past few years.
That surprises me a little bit. This is the race. This is where it all comes down to. And Courtney, who we've seen always out the front, just sort of floated around. Normally she'd be flying around that Cairn. This is the big finish.
It is, and Liz Plumers is out in front as we see some of those in the middle of the field. Liz, Harriet, then it's Rebecca Creedy, then it is Courtney Hancock.
Liz Plumers, look at her head down there, Reese.
Pushing over that. There it is. That's the difference.
And look at her, managed to stay on the board and just crush through this little surf. Liz Plumers, brilliant stuff from Liz, and she powers up the beach now. Liz Plumers, the dominant force of the Iron Women Series for Nutri-Grain right throughout this summer. Brilliant stuff, Liz. Big smile on the face, the big beaming smile. That is outstanding work from Liz Plumers. A big battle for second. Creedy just gets ahead of Harriet Brown. Courtney will slide across. Let's get down to Ashlyn.
Oh, congratulations, Liz, number four. How does that feel?
Oh, amazing. The girls pushed me so hard then, it just felt like they were always coming down behind me, and I was just like, oh gosh, it was so good to get that final wave.
You must be feeling pretty confident about the series right now.
Yeah, I mean, there's still one to go, and there's not that many points in it really that anything can happen, but I'm stoked to come away with another win.
Congratulations, Liz. Fantastic race.
Yeah, it was good.
She's very modest there, not many points in it. She's well ahead, Liz Plumers, and she's going to be terribly hard to catch. That smile is infectious. She's been brilliant all summer. Let's have a look at how we sit after the women's round five. Liz Plumers, Rebecca Creedy, Harriet Brown, Courtney Hancock and Amy Nerfen. They were our top five today. Brodie Moyer still managed to hang in there to get sixth. Then we turn the page. Tiane Raymond, a tough day for her. Emma Dick was up the front there for a while but had to slide down towards the end. Liz and Harriet with a nice embrace and a little giggle. Not much laughing out in the water, but happy it's all over. The men are coming up. This is Channel 9's Wide World of Sports. Stick around.
Well, it was a long long race, and it was a tight one. It wasn't until a wave in the final stages of the very last leg that helped Liz Plumers pull away from the leading pack finally and seal the victory. So for the fourth time this series, there's Liz Plumers on top of the podium. Rebecca Creedy hung on to claim second prize. Harriet Brown is there in third. Welcome back to Newcastle Beach. Reese, what a tight race.
Wow, it was unreal race. That was so good to watch. I couldn't believe how much the lead changed. We had people going from first to last and vice versa. It was crazy how often that lead changed. But Liz Plumers, she is so good. She is just a full professional, and she just keeps putting the pressure and pressure on the other athletes until they break. And she did that again. She was on fire.
Yeah, she did. Let's have a look at just how much of a lead she has now on the overall series points ladder. There she is in first position, 13 points ahead of Rebecca Creedy. It's going to take a lot to dethrone her right now. Harriet Brown still hanging in there in third position. Courtney Hancock has moved up to equal fifth. She finished fourth today. It was a strong race for her. Maddie Dunn's there, equal fifth on 58 points. Emma Dick rounds out the top eight.
Now we look over the page. Now we see Crystal Smith. That's a big jump for her. She's into number nine. So she's breathing down the young girls next there. Tara Coleman, Amy Nerth, and they're tied on 10th. They're not out of making that top 10 either.
Right, the Ironman race is coming up next. I can't wait for this one. Whose day is it going to be? It could be anyone's.
It could be. It's an opportunity, though, for guys like Ali Day, who's leading the series, to really take it to Shannon next time. He did it in round one and won this same format. So, and Shannon didn't race well in this particular format. So it's an opportunity for Ali Day to go out there and stamp his claim on this series. Guys like Pooley and Kendrick, they looked in great form in the last few rounds. They'll be putting a lot of pressure on those top two guys as well. So it's going to be a ding-dong battle out there, that's for sure, because it is flat out there, a few little waves, and it is really hot. So interesting racing on its way.
Yeah, and let's remind ourselves of just how close the men's series is this year. Ali Day is our leader, but only by 2 points. Shannon Eckstein is breathing down his neck in second position on 64 points. Kai Hurst is coming in on third. Matt Poole there in fourth. Kendrick Louie on 48 points. Wes Berg in sixth position. Luke Cuff rounding out the top eight.
We look over the page. Once again, there's Tannen Linden trying to sneak into that top eight. He'll be putting a lot of pressure on those guys. Nathan Smith, he'll be looking for a great result. Then we look down in equal 12, Jackson Maynard and Kane Eckstein, who's not normally back in that position.
Well, joining us now is Kai Hurst, who is preparing to compete in today's Ironman race. Kai, you're in third position overall, two rounds to go. The title is there for the taking. How badly do you want it?
Oh, yeah, you know, I want it as bad as anyone else, you know. It's one of those things, this whole season we haven't seen any swell, and the same again today. I was hoping that nor'easter would really kick in. They were predicting 30, 40 knots, but, you know, it certainly hasn't come. It's a beautiful day for a dip. But, yeah, look, it's going to make it really hard, I think, for me to get moved from that third position into first. You know, the other two guys, Ali Day, Shannon Eckstein, have to have, you know, shockers, really, at the end of the day. So realistically, I can't see that happening. But, you know, I'm here just to address today's race and take it as it comes and you know, race as best as I can.
All right, mate, you talked briefly about the race today. You talked to me earlier about having slow starts at the races. How are your tactics today? What are you going to do today to try and get that win that I keep telling everyone you're going to do?
Yeah, you know what? I just seem to just be really slow and a little bit lethargic off the line. Today we got swim first. So for me, I don't really want to bust it too hard. You know, I want to take it out nice and comfortably and sort of build the race. And this season, you know, for me, it's just been about building the race. And obviously, I've just been moving at the wrong times. And, you know, I guess if I can move at the right time, you know, I'll set myself up for a great race.
Well, all the best out there today, Kai. We hope you go well. Well, don't go anywhere because the Ironman race is coming up next. Kai is about to do battle with Ali, Shannon, Kendrick, Pooley and the rest of them. Plenty of enthusiasm and experience among all those athletes, but one athlete in particular who has no shortage of either of those traits is Wes Berg. Let's check him out.
Honestly, there's not much that can beat the ocean. It covers three quarters of the earth, you know. It's who we are, it's around us, it's what our body's made up of water. It's the coolest thing ever. I guess it all just started with Joel, really.
I know that he's got a lot of water knowledge and makes it a lot easier to train in and out of the water when someone understands, you know, both aspects of the ocean and also in the gym.
And then it just snowballed, you know. The opportunity to work with Andy Irons, achieved some amazing things with him, and he's probably one of the most raw surfers ever. I now train Ock, who's, you know, been one of my childhood idols. The worst thing you ever want to do as an athlete is become a number, and I suppose getting in the way of letting the youth come through. I finished seventh last year. Basically, I was injured and only a couple of points behind sixth, and I kind of thought to myself, well, you know what, if you can finish seventh and a couple of points behind sixth being injured, then imagine what you could do fresh and ready to go. So, you know, I love it. I love the challenge of stepping on that line. And that's when the questions, and if there's any doubt, come straight at you. And if you've done the work and you're strong enough to kind of squish them and step them out of your mind, then I feel you deserve to be there. And at the moment, I can't wait to race because I really want to challenge and test myself against these guys this season.
They're on the start line, the nerves and the adrenaline is pumping. It's race time. Once again, your commentators are Trevor Hendy, Rhys Drury and Tim Gilbert.
Thank you, Ashlyn. Yeah, a nice warm day here in Newcastle. 27, 28 degrees as we look at our start list. And, of course, last year's series winner was Shannon Eckstein, and he wears the one. Then it's Kai Hurst, Kendrick Louie, Matt Poole, Kane Eckstein, Tannen Linden, Maynard and Bevilacqua, then who turned the page. Jack Moyes, of course, from Terrigal, just down the coast, got his big fan club here today. Smith, Cuff, Alan Hamilton, Ali Day and Wes Berg in 15. Yeah, Jack Moyes has quite a few people as Sam Hamilton does it his way. Of course, Wes Berg, we saw the piece on him. And Matty Poole and Shannon Eckstein went toe-to-toe here last year. It was great stuff. Kendrick Louie and the boys all just giving us a little wave. And Kai Hurst, the eyes and a bit of a shake of the biceps. Newcastle, round five. And we're off.
Oh, already a big move straight across to the right there. There's a famous little Newcastle rip on the left-hand side. And for some reason, they're not going to use that now because the bank's so shallow, but someone's chosen to run right across to the right.
Well said, Trevor Hendy. And Rhys, 600 metres here in the swim.
And look how big that wade was for these guys. That tide's really gone out. So they had to run really fast, get those legs up out to the side and wade through that water.
All right, it's the M format here with the men. They do it three times round. We saw the girls do it twice. The men will do it three times, and we're starting with the swim, Trev.
Yeah, this is the M format of our three formats, an endurance-style format. We see the swim leg first. They've got to go in and out twice, so we see a lot of moves and changes. I love watching this one. Ski leg second, of course, we run back around, we jump on the board, and as you say, Tim, three times. It's a long day's racing, particularly when it's this flat and this hard work.
All the work they've done is going to have to pay off here. It's a grinding endurance event as we see them all over the top of each other at the Cairns.
See, they're bunched on that first get. Look at it. Fists and arms.
And that's Jack Moyes right at the back of that pack there. You can see him. He is the local with the big Jack pack on the beach cheering him on. But look how tight they all are together. And, of course, we're going to see this stretch out. But right now, it is bumping shoulders. Here comes a little wave here, Ken. That's Nathan Smith out in front. Gets a little run from it, but can't turn it into anything.
Very congested right at the moment, and there's not a lot of waves to look at. The boys just thumping away. And just remember, they're going at about 30 seconds for the 50, over 600 metres, so it's not just an easy paddle.
Oh, there's Smitty.
Just misses it.
He's such a good swimmer, it's Nathan Smith.
Now look at this. They're all going to get on this, boys.
Make room for Nathan Smith in the middle. And he joins the wave as well. Imagine that. Not
how often do we see that?
That's crazy. Absolutely crazy.
Oh, they're going to come around the run here. Australian Championships a couple of years ago, 15 people ended up on a wave sprinting to the finish. There was one person in the field that wasn't on it. This time we've got 15. It's the whole field on the one wave. That's sensational. Look at that. We're back to the start.
And an anecdote of where this sport is at, isn't it? There's so many great athletes.
Oh, look, I've been so impressed this year watching the series. The depth of talent now is really, really running deep, and these are some incredible athletes amongst these young kids, and it's getting harder and harder to get in this series.
That's why it means so much to finish in that top eight. As we have a look at the replay here, Reese, all on the wave together.
This is absolutely, mate. Look how many heads are on this. They're all surfing it really well, hands out in front, heads up, sucking in that oxygen. Luke Cuffey, that was awesome.
Yeah, the Cairns, the battle of the Cairns again. No friends at the Cairns, as Trev says. And basically what I was alluding to with the top eight, you need to finish in that eight to get a guaranteed spot in the series next year.
You do. Sam Hamm just dropping a little bit off the back of that pack. It's all about the points for the city. This is their livelihood. This is what they do. This is their passion, their dream. Every time they go out there and they deal with these waves and the swells and the other competitors, everything going on, remember, their dream is actually like eluding them or getting a little step closer. So there's a lot going through these guys, not only physically, but their mind, their emotion, everything out there. And yes, they're all back together, but their heart rate's 180, so it's not like the start of the race anymore. They're already be starting to hurt.
And such a narrow lead for Ali Day. Can he win the series? This is round five. We have round six to come and only 2 points. There is Ali as he looks up at the camera, and just next to him, the man he wants to beat. Ali Day's on 66. Shannon Eckstein is 64.
They pretty much had to swim the whole way there. A few of the guys are getting a little rum, but they swam to the beach and these guys. That would have been hard work, as we see Matty Poole leading the way.
Yeah, a great endurance athlete, Matt Poole, isn't he?
Oh, and how impressive has his swim leg become? So we see Kendrick Louie just in front of Kai Hurst in third. They actually, Kane Eckstein's ducked in front of him. But it shows you how much Matty Poole's swim leg has improved. It was never a bad swim leg, but it's become a real weapon now.
Yep, see, it is him out in front, Matt Poole. Kendrick Louie, Shannon there around five or six, and now the ski leg, 1,160 metres. We do this three times as well. And this is the way it is after the first swim. Matt Poole, Kendrick Louie, Kane Eckstein, Kai Hurst, Jack Moyes, and Shannon Eckstein, Tannen Linden, Ali Day, Matt Bevilacqua, Jackson Maynard. So that's after the first swim. We have three swims today. The guys are on the ski today. Three skis and, of course, three boards as well. Nine's Y World of Sports. We've got plenty more after this. We're on the ski, Channel 9's Wide World of Sports, the Ironman Series, thanks to Nutri-Grain. Round five at Newcastle, and you can see Matt Poole out in front, not far behind him, Shannon Eckstein. You can see out to the right-hand side is Kendrick Louie, and it's all tight, isn't it? Look at them all go.
Wow, all in one wave together, Kane Eckstein on this side. And the back in the yellow ski there jumping on the wave was Kai Hurst. Couldn't get onto that wave with everybody else.
Yeah, nine of them on the first wave, Trev.
Yeah, look at Shannon Eckstein. Picks his ski up. He doesn't drag it. That's a big move. It takes a little bit more strength. But look, no dragging, no getting caught up with everyone else. Matt Poole on his inside. But Shannon Eckstein bunny hopping off to the right there. That's a move in itself. That's not accidental. Shannon Eckstein's thinking about what he's doing.
Yeah, the professor, he's put the research in. Shannon Eckstein just trailing Ali Day in the series as he booms out to the right towards the jet ski.
Oh, and you can see there, he slid out there, Trevor. He didn't get hit. Poorly copped that little one on the lap. A few of the other guys are getting whacked here. So a great move from Shannon Eckstein.
Oh, when you go back over it, you see these little things afterwards and you realise where Shannon just sneaks in front and does it. He's been the master for years and years now.
Look at these.
Look at these two last boys hitting these swells on the inside. That's Sam Hamm on the back right.
Hayden Allum Hayden there Allum with him as well.
Oh, yeah. One more here.
Oh, have some of that, it says.
Oh, and Sam Hamilton off he goes. Oh,
oh no, he's not going to lie. He's already at the back of the pack. That happens, that hurts. He'll be thinking he'll drop his head here now. He's going to get another one on the lap here. Look at the difference. There's Shannon Eckstein way out in front. This is Sam Hamm. All of a sudden, this bunch field is spread right out. That's Ironman racing.
Yeah, here's a replay up front. Oh, Matt Poole pointing to the sky, and Shannon just cruising through.
Wow, that was a great picture. Poole did really well to stay on his ski and punch through that wave. But Shannon again. But here we are with Hayden Allum and Sam Hamilton at the back. Bang, crash. Sam Hamm off his ski. Wow.
Don't want to be mean-spirited, but you can almost throw the Benny Hill music behind the boys at the back. They're getting crushed. Oh, here we go again.
He gets lifted out of his seat. Look at that. Bang, popped off to the side. No one can stop that from happening. He needed to lean a little bit more forward, be a little bit more focused, and he might have got through that one. Sam Hamm, very popular, but at the back of the pack now.
And he is a bit of a ham, old Sam, but these guys are doing it well out in front. Shannon Eckstein and just to his left, Matty Poole. So Shannon just looks like he's a day out paddling away. And Ali Day, of course, his number one adversary.
And here we are on board with Ali Day. Nice raid. He's always looking around, looking controlled. But again, look at these top guys again. They're all going to get on their front wave. I think I'd see Matt Bevilacqua there as well.
Poole. Oh, Ali down. Ali comes. Wee. And so it's Ali, then it's Shannon. We can also see Matt Poole.
Oh, Jack Moyes slewed, but stood up. Look how close and shallow it is in there.
Wow, with the new pointier fronts on the skis too, that's when you get holes in your skis. So these boys, the handlers will be back there checking them out. But Matt Poole's still looking really strong on this side.
Yeah, so Matty Poole and Matt Bevilacqua now right up the front. So that is one of the skis down. Of course, we're doing this three times for the men in the M format. And they'll cruise around and they will jump on the board. So Matty Bevilacqua, the Matt's doing it out in front at the moment. Him and Matty Poole.
Kai Hurst coming through. He's trailing. It was Wes Berg at the back of that pack. But I can't believe the pace as we look at the placings.
Yeah, after ski one, Bevilacqua, Poole, Day, Eckstein and Jack Moyes with his gang from Terrigal. Kane Eckstein, Kendrick Louis, Wes Berg, Luke Cuff and Tannen Linden, our top 10.
Reece, I'm watching this race and seeing it's already spreading out, but it's because the front pack is going so fast. The way Ali Day paddled out in those first couple of strokes, look at him. He's moved into the lead there. These boys mean business.
When it's like this, these flatter conditions, there's one thing with Ali Day, Matty Poole and Matty Bev, they're super, super fit and they can keep going at this pace all day. So they're going to put a lot of pressure on Shannon Eckstein. They're going to keep pushing this pace all day long.
Ali Day out in front. You can see Matty Poole just to his left and Shannon Eckstein, they make up the top three. Then Kendrick Louis, he's made his way through the field. Wes Berg, Wes is always up there. Kane Eckstein, and they're almost in Indian file as we see Matty Bevilacqua there as well.
There we are with Jack Moyes. He's still hanging in there. Then a gap back to Tannen Linden. And there's Kai Hurst at the back of that backpack on that yellow board. That's a really slow start. He really needs to start putting in it on this leg.
And here's Wes Berg, 18th year. And what a professional he is. How fit is Wes Berg?
Super fit, knows what it takes. Looked after Joel Parkinson in that World Championship year and a couple of others because he knows what it takes to get the best out of yourself. He's an incredible board paddler. They're riding these runs. Unusual to see Shannon Eckstein not taking this. Ali Davis.
Oh, Ali cruises off the top.
This is our series leader. Round five, picks up a wave. Could this be what makes a difference ultimately? That's going to be a big gap.
Ali Day, of course, missing last year, back with a vengeance and leading the series.
And what I love about it is we saw him make that move at the start of the board leg. He pushed to the lead. That's what champions do. He took it in his own hands. That's not luck. That's intent. That's a very, very powerful will. He's decided to get out there and he's put in the hard work. Good on him.
Awfully difficult summer for him last year with the chronic fatigue as we see Shannon Eckstein come around and Matt Poole just behind him. The Iron Women, they were brilliant earlier on. Liz Plume is the dominant force. But of course, Rebecca Creedy was up there, as was Harriet Brown. Let's get down to Ashlyn Krukellis on the beach.
Well, I'm here with Harriet Brown, who placed third in the Iron Women race a short time ago. Congratulations, Harriet. You're certainly making yourself at home on the podium this season. You're right out there with Liz Plumas for a lot of that race. You must have been hoping you'd get her at some point.
Oh, I was definitely hoping, but Liz is such a good athlete, and I think I was actually pretty lucky to be up there with her. I was wash riding her most of the way and then catching a few waves to stay up with her. So, I was really pleased with my race. I was coming second most of the way, and then Creedy and Courtney just caught a wave at the end there, so ended up with third, which I'm actually really pleased with.
And we'll finish with the Eliminator round, of course. What are you expecting in that one? What are you hoping for? It'd be nice to get a win, wouldn't it?
Oh, I would absolutely love a win, but it's so tough out there. I'm really just hoping to race each race to get through to the next round, so you can't be complacent. I'll be focusing on recovery and just hoping that I can feel good in that next race.
Congratulations, Harriet. Good luck in round six.
Thank you.
Yeah, brilliant work, Harriet Brown. She's been right there. We've got some argy-bargy on the cans, and Harriet, a great talker as well.
really is, and come so far in the last couple of years, and I love seeing the fact she's made that step as we see Ellie Day. Look at this, Reese. This is outstanding. He's put his head down. He's got to get over it.
Oh, wow, wee. That's great paddling. It's like someone flicks the switch with Ellie Day. Once he gets out in front and gets a sniff, he just lifts the rate, lifts the intensity. Boom, out in front, off he goes.
Yeah, the ultimate endurance athlete, isn't he, Ellie Day? First up onto the beach after the board here.
Wow.
And Matt Poole, not bad, himself just behind him, and Shannon Eckstein. So this is interesting, these little waves just on the beach.
It's Kane Eckstein with Poole now, so Kane's making a move as well.
Speaking of endurance athletes, yeah. Through comes Kane Eckstein
to
claim the title. Hey, what about me? Unbelievable. Had to pull out of the Coolangatta Gold this year, leading just up in front of Josh Minogue with the torn bicep. He's come back, had a few problems with it, but look at him there now. He's one of the superstars of our sport. He's done a lot for our sport in the way he's taken it around the world. And there he is. Comes to the front when it gets long.
Yeah, those pull-ups got some great coverage. Kane Eckstein here, the pocket rocket that he is. But Ellie Day, look how far ahead he is at the moment as we launch into the 600-metre swim. And Matty Poole in third position. Shannon Eckstein cruises around. So after the board, it's Ellie Day, Kane Eckstein, Matt Poole, Shannon Eckstein, Matt Bevilacqua. That's the top five. On to Kendrick Louie. Then it's Wes Berg, Luke Cuff, Jack Moyes, the kid from just down the coast, and Nathan Smith. How will this all end up? Look at the cruise, man. Ellie Day on the beautiful green board. We've got plenty more on Wide World of Sports coming up.
That's it. Kick your buddy in the face.
Thank you, water, for being my teacher.
Thank you, water, for being my teacher.
Face the water.
Now we're doing push-ups.
Deep water, that's coming soon to Nine, and that's just one of the trips we missed out on, boys. But we're at Newcastle today, and it's looking good. Wes Berg, of course, has done well, but that's the man right at the moment, Ellie Day. Little bit of backstroke, and he catches the wave.
Wonderful piece of body surfing there. Picks it up and looks for it. Once again, he knows what he's doing. He's thinking about it. Head down, watch those hands side by side now, and onto the shallow sand. Takes that little stroke, feels the sand. That's how he knows it's shallow enough with his eyes closed to get up. And consummate professional now, Ellie Day, really coming through, knows exactly what he's doing.
Yeah, he was at deep water over in the United States, and he'll come around shortly as our leader, not only of this race, but of the series, Ellie Day. And Matt Poole,
he's starting to link these waves up too. Like, that's another jump he got on these guys. So he's actually increasing the lead from Pooley and Kane. So once you're out in front, sometimes you get on a roll in this M-shaped type format.
Yeah, these are all big endurance athletes, as is Shannon Eckstein now. He's in fourth.
Wow, we're only missing Kendrick Louie now, because look at that field. Those front four are so strong over this distance. As we go back to Ellie Day on the ski leg, 1,160 metres with the two laps. Look at that technique, really, really strong. Doesn't get a hell of a lot of rotation, but he's super, super fit. He just grinds away.
So after swim two, Ellie Day, Matt Poole, Kane Eckstein, Shannon, his brother, and Matt Bevilacqua. That's our top five. Then it's Kendrick, Wes, Kai, Luke Cuff, and Tannen Linden. They're our top 10. Three times we're doing this. We're in the M format with the guys.
I can't believe how spread out this race has become. We saw the women's earlier today and how bunched they were, but this field has just spread so far out, and Ellie Day is just going for it out in front. Look at that lead he's got. It's massive.
It wasn't so long ago that they were all on the same wave, all 15 of them. There's Kendrick.
What struck me too when they ran around there on the run legs was that the way they were puffing again. It is super hot out here today, and it's hard, hard work, and it's really, really starting to affect these boys.
So Matt Poole, we're on board with him right at the moment. It was all the histrionics of him and Shannon Eckstein last year, and very, very different schools of thought as to who was right and who was wrong, as a few other boys making over the wave, and Ali comes down the other.
This is what I'm talking about. This is a big wave. He's going to hold it straight, and he's done it beautifully. But again, he's linked up another wave, Trevor. He's increasing this lead every time he comes in. He's getting a wave, and up he goes, dragging around. But look at this wave out the back.
Just hanging on to it.
So Kane Eckstein's going to join Matt Poole on this, and Matt Poole had done a lot of work to get away there. And one thing to point out with Ali, he's not getting the waves from way out the back, but he is getting them every time.
Yeah, Matt Poole and Kane Eckstein. Matt just going sideways there. Currently fourth in the series. He's going well.
Oh, look, in a perfect world, you know, if I could walk away with two high-end podium finishes, a couple of first and seconds, I'd be really stoked with that. The point score, you just got to let that roll out as it plays out. Like I said before, in the swell and the conditions here at Newcastle, quite easily we could see one of those top guys have a shocker result, have a throwaway, and, you know, mathematically it's still possible for me to win the series, but it is unlikely. So I'd need those two top guys to bail out, Kai to finish back a little bit as well, and... yeah, I guess in the series, you know, it's not over till it's over. As we keep seeing day in, day out, these series just keep turning on them on their heads race after race.
Yeah, they sure do. Great to hear from Matt Poole, and I love that little bit of argy-bargy last year. I actually think he didn't do anything wrong with Shannon Eckstein. As we look at the replay here of Ali Day just cruising down the wave.
Yeah, it's a great shot of Ali. He's getting better and better at making sure that all of these little bits go right. He doesn't make mistakes in this spot. Here he is. He paddles to stay out in front. The white water's going to explode. He needs the nose right out in front, and there it is. Hits the back of the ski. That's the critical moment, and he pulls it off perfectly.
Yeah, well done, Ali Day. It was interesting to see the two interviews earlier on with Shannon and Pooley about that incident last year where they bumped around the cans, and they still don't agree, do they?
Yeah, they think they've agreed, but they haven't. Pooley still thinks he's done nothing wrong. But that's the way it goes. That's the beauty of the sport. Whoa. There's all these different personalities. Look at the run across the back two here. It was Tannen Lennon
on the edge. He was having a lot of hassles. But then we saw Ali Day getting out the back, pushing on these runners. But Pooley and Kane, I think they've actually closed in on Ali a little bit. I think they've actually cut into his lead a touch. So the boys behind are really trying hard to try and wheel in Ali Day as he slides over a little one. Good surfing again there from Ali. Yeah, but I think they're catching him.
Yeah, they definitely are, as he just jumps off the ski and Ali Day charges up the beach, and the boys behind him aren't far behind, and they are two of the great Australian endurance athletes. We're talking Matt Poole and Kane Eckstein, but Ali at the moment's got that sweet Nova Castrian grin as he marches through the sand at Newcastle, round five of the Nutri-Grain Ironman series. And he had that webbing problem with his feet. He seems to be over that now. Kane and Matt side by side. And Ali is now the hunted.
It's not that long ago that no one would stick with Kane Eckstein. Matt Poole doing it so, so well. He's got a few more seasons under his belt, more confidence. And look at him, knows exactly what to do, taking the drink, because that's going to pay off for him in the second half.
Yeah, 26-year-old Matt Poole. And he won a race here in Newcastle last year, as we mentioned, just ahead of this guy, and it was that exact can where he pushed him in the sand via his knee, actually. It wasn't your conventional push, was it, Reese?
Apparently not. But here we are, back with Ali Day.
Yeah, we won't go over old ground. Can it be, or will it be, Ali's day today after Ski 2? He leads the way, Matt Poole, Kane Eckstein, Shannon, and Matt Bevilacqua. That's our top five. Sixth position at the moment is Kendrick Louis, then Wesberg, Kai Hurst, Jackson Maynard, Luke Cuff. How will it all end here at Newcastle, round five? Plenty more after this. Channel 9's Wide World of Sports. He's out there on his own, but he's being chased by Matt Poole and Kane Eckstein. Great skills again, Ali. Look at him come.
That, again, is so good. He's just seeming to link them up every time. But, again, it's his rate. He's putting the pressure on. He's really taking it to these guys. Good work, Ali Day.
Yeah, he's doing. He just looks so strong, doesn't he? So together. And I noticed a couple of times when he's running up the beach, he shortens his stride when he runs uphill. He does everything right. He's doing all the little things right. And that, at the end of the day, that's what makes an Ironman into an Ironman champion, because you got to get all the little bits right, come in the right spot. As we see these two boys having a ding-dong battle in second and third, and they won't be thinking about second place. They'll be thinking about catching Ellie Day, and they're quite capable of it. Anyone's race still.
Yeah, Matt Poole and Kane Eckstein.
Shannon down one in the back there, just behind the flag. He's hanging in there as well. This is going to be a big finish as we get into the second half of the race.
What about Ellie Day, Trev? Look, obviously, you've done it all in this sport. What are your thoughts on him as we look at a replay of Shannon first, the 8-time champion of the series? Will he be a 9-time champion as he comes down? They're great pitches, aren't they?
Oh, perfect handling of a difficult situation. Doesn't look much, but to get that nose up on a 10-foot-6-long paddleboard in that short amount of time, very, very good. But back to your question, Ellie Day doing exceptional. Here's Kane Eckstein, and so strong, so good over these distances, just keeps putting those strokes in. Right now he's resting, you know, taking it easy, but he knows what he's doing. He'll be sitting on Matt Poole's wash. But Ellie Day, here he comes, coming into this can. It's all the little things. He's built up this experience. A little while back there was a little bit about no more Mr. Nice Guy, he's too nice. I said to Ellie, mate, that's who you are, just be yourself. For the kids out there, be like Ellie Day, you know, care about other people. You know, acknowledge Shannon Eckstein, the legend, all this sort of stuff. It works for him because he knows where he fits and he's building his way up, and he looks like the champion to me.
There's another great young man, Kendrick Lewis, similar sort of vintage to Ellie Day. 24, 25-year-olds, they definitely are the future of this sport, and it's in good hands.
Very much so. Kendrick's a great bloke and very different from Ellie as well. But look at Kane Eckstein trying to chase Pooley. Look at Pooley, he's pushing onto this runner. He's trying to get over it.
Yes, he has.
And Ellie Day again out the front. He's got a little one, but Pooley is chasing so hard. And he's got that look in his eye, Trevor. He really wants to get Ellie Day.
I love it when Matt Poole does this, because there's something about him. He's that character that we haven't had in the series for a while that chases, has got the grunt, and look at him. He's done that one. He never ever gives up, and he believes and sees himself at the top of the podium. I love it.
Yeah, here he comes, Matty Poole charging up the beach. And someone was asking me during the week, why do they splash the cold bottle of water on themselves when they've been out swimming in the water for so long, or on a board for so long, getting splashed by water?
Well, you answered that question because it's a cold bottle of water. So the water temperature is often not as cold as that one that comes out of the esky, and don't underestimate the value of a bit of fresh water running over your face as well. It changes the perspective of things.
Oh, that's good, because that's exactly the way I explained it to them when they asked me, and I didn't know what I was talking about. As we watch the boys charge back into the surf, and Shannon not letting them out of their sight.
You are becoming an expert, Tim, aren't you? You know exactly what's going on now. You've been around long enough.
Yeah, well, I do, and I'm absolutely loving it. You really get involved, don't you? He's done well.
Oh, Matty Bevilacqua, you know, Reese, I'm loving this kid from Tassie. I reckon the whole of Tasmania should get behind him, because that's a rarity for such a good Ironman to come from the Apple Isle.
After board two, Ellie Day, Matt Poole, Kane Eckstein, Shannon, Matt Bevilacqua. We just mentioned him, the Tasmanian boy, and Kendrick charges up with the goggles on, and... Yeah, that's the way we sit after the second board leg, now in the swim.
Yeah, it's great to see Bevy up there. He's been very frustrated this season. He had a great season last year. This year, not so good. But for him to be in that top five, you know, he could try and sneak into this top eight again.
Yeah, just to make up the top ten, it's Kendrick, Wes, Kai, Luke Cuff and Jackson Maynard. So there's our top ten as we look again at Ellie.
It's a good question, isn't it? We start talking about where you're from, you know, Tassie, and we've also been talking about the personalities. Ellie Day, Mr. Nice Guy, Matt Poole chases everybody down.
Great.
You know, I wonder the people at home who they get behind, who they think, oh, that's my guy, you know, that's my girl in the series, because there's some unique athletes. Not only are they extraordinary athletes, they're really different and unique people, and I love it. It's a very, very colourful series right now.
A little bit of backstroke. He's mixing it up in the medley. There is Ellie Day. And I'm sure there are people who want to see Shannon Eckstein just get pipped, because yeah, he's been a champion for so long. There's those obviously that are on the Eckstein bandwagon, but others will say, oh, can someone just knock him off?
Look at Ellie Day doing some backstroke out the back. Here we go. Matty Poole and Kane Eckstein's just fallen off it, but Matty Poole has cracked a great wave, and he's going to come out with Ellie Day. So all that hard work, all that chasing, game on.
Yeah, what about Matt Poole there? That's absolutely outstanding work.
Wow.
So just a little turn around these flags and Matt Poole is right on Ali Day. There'd be a few people out there seeing who'd want to see Shannon get beaten, wouldn't they?
Yeah, and I don't think it's really about Shannon. I think they just want somebody else to come through. A lot of people, Shannon's a wonderful fellow. He's done so much for the sport and the series and everything else. And of course, he's going to keep winning these races. But there's so many of these young guys coming through. And as Aussies, we always love, you know, the underdog to come through. And I think it's just a little bit of that. Shannon Eckstein's an absolute champion. He's not made any enemies in the sport, no doubt at all. And he's super, super good at it. But you see guys like Matty Poole, Ali Day, get rewarded for their effort, like Matt Poole just did on that wave. And there's Matty Bev we talked about. We saw Shannon run in front of the screen. This is a hot series. This is super, super hot to get into it. And it's a super effort to actually come up the pointy end like these guys.
Yeah, and I think it's a brilliant point you make. It's not about Shannon Eckstein. This is not about the individual, the eight-time champion. It is about those underdogs and it's about other characters coming through the sport, and now they are.
Absolutely, they are. And look at these boys out in front. Poole is sitting right on Ali's shoulder, trying to get a wash off him. And Kane Eckstein working really hard. He'll be trying to get up onto Pooley's feet so he can get onto his wash. But those two boys out in front, look at the rate. They are going for it.
Matt Poole is like a grinding machine. Look at him just on his shoulder. Won't let Ali out of his sight. So they're ding-dong at the moment. Ali was there with a big, big lead. Just fresh air, and Kane not far behind them now.
Look at that stroke rate of Kane Eckstein. He's really, really pushing hard. And once again, that word intent has come through a few times today. He wants to be in that front pack. What can he do? Can he pick up a little swell and bridge that gap?
Yeah, Mother Nature's not helping them too much today, Reece. Just trying to claw onto this little break.
Yeah, it's a grueling race and it's a long race. They're going to have to swim all the way to the beach here. They might get a little bump here, but they're going to stand up and they're going to porpoise dive. And let's see who gets up first. Kay may get a little lift. No, misses that. Here they go. They'll push onto this.
Oh,
rest Pooley.
How's the rhythm change for Ali Day? He was right in rhythm getting the waves. Now he's not. Now he's waiting for them.
Yeah, and I think Matt Poole is going to come up onto the beach first here, just ahead of Ali Day, or they're right next to each other.
Wow, look at this. Training partners side by side in the Michael King, the Mooloolaba Academy up there on the Sunshine Coast. Ali Day originally from the south coast of New South Wales. And look at him. Matt Poole's a giant, isn't he? He's a big boy, big and strong. And Ali's just more of that, you know, he turns it over, ticks it over. And two exceptional athletes.
And they're both really close mates too, aren't they, out of the water?
Yeah, they get on really well. And, you know, especially they spend so much time training together up there on the Sunshine Coast. But here we are with Kane Eckstein. He's not giving in. And Shannon, he's not too far away. Don't write this guy off. He's the champion and is. He's looking a little bit distressed, though, on his face.
The M format is an endurance format. And today, with the surf as it is, it's even died a little bit over the last little while. It makes it even tougher as we see them burn out on the ski, Matty Poole and Ali Day.
That is very, very tough. And Shannon Eckstein at the moment chasing.
Matt Poole leads the way after swim three. Ali Day, Eckstein, Eckstein, Bevilacqua. Our top five. Plenty more after this. Nine's Wide World of Sports. It's Matt Poole and Ali Day out in front. Round five of the Nutri-Grain Ironman Series. Ali had it all to himself there for a while, but Matt Poole, his training partner, right with him, right on the edge of this wave.
Oh, and it's heating up, isn't it? Like, this is how these guys have been racing the last couple of seasons. Super close. Matt Poole's never, ever far behind. He's always trying to catch up with his back. Ali Day is really coming through. There's Kane Eckstein. He's had a rough season so far, coming back showing how good he is. And just behind him, he's out of screen at the moment, but Shannon Eckstein, the master, is thinking about the point score right now, going, no, I've got to be up in that top three or so.
Ali Day, ahead of this, was leading by two. Shannon Eckstein.
Oh, he just punches through Matt Poole. Matt Poole hung back a little bit there to basically wear it on the chest so he didn't get knocked off.
Yeah, Kane's in third, then Shannon's a fourth. That's the way this race is. But as we watch Ali Day here again, the replay coming into it right now. Whee!
Punching through it, and Poole in the background, bang, stopped him wearing that one on the chest. That'll let Kane catch up a little bit too, you think. And he has.
Yeah, he has.
You can see Kane. He's not too far out of it now. And Shannon Eckstein, he's not too far away either. But Ali Day out in front. I love this technique. Nice low arms. He just rates up and just keeps going. Pooley trying to get over onto his wash as we see Matty Bev punching through one on the shore.
Yeah, and as I was mentioning, just 2 points, but a nice little smile.
Go harder, baby. Go harder.
The Apple Isle. 66 for Ali Day. That's points for the series. And Shannon Eckstein, 64. So that's how close it is when Trev talks about the tactics that are going on here. Ali, first around. Now Matt just going behind him here. Matt Poole.
I love watching these skis, how they pick up runners. They pick up anything. You see here Kane, as soon as they get a little lift in the tail, away they go. And look at the rate from Kane there. Really rating up, coming back at these top two guys.
And Ali Day gets a little bit of a run there away from Matty Poole. Watch him chase. Look at this. In the centre of the screen with a dark blue ski chasing Ali Day. He's going to come up close to his tail. Kane Eckstein back there going, hang on, this is what I normally do. He's chasing as well. Wow, and remember, their heart rate's going to be, it's never going to get below 170 in this race. It's right up there, they're just hanging in there.
And it's set up beautifully for the last round as well. Round five! There they go. They get a moment to breathe, Ali Day and Matt Poole, as they come down that wave. But it's going to be so close after this that round six will be unbelievable. Ali Day just ahead of Matt Poole as they launch their way up to the beach.
Look at the speed they're going now. They would have tried to lower the heart rate as quick as they could on that little wave, up going on those legs. And look at the speed they're going at the back end of this race. That is very, very impressive.
Oh, I'm inspired. This is brilliant. Watching these two, the way they do it, they're taking it to a whole new level. There's the master of the endurance race, chasing behind, hanging in there. And there's the all-time master, Shannon Eckstein,
closing
right behind.
In.
Oh, this is going to be a ding-dong finish.
Yeah, there was a time there we had all 15 on the same wave. We're now on the final board leg, and it's come down to this. Kane Eckstein in third position, the bronze medal. Out in front of him is Matt Poole and Ali Day. Just behind him, big brother Shannon. And that's a good view, isn't it? As he carves in and rolls. Oh.
Wow, that's a little section. We'll get to see that again. He's rolled over there. Right at that time, it's going to stop him in the tracks. Bang, hits the next one. Kane Eckstein was on a roll there. He was really, really chasing those front two, and that's held him back. And there's that gap that's opened back up again. That hurts. It won't hurt him because he just eats stuff like that up. But that was me. I'd be just thoroughly disappointed right now.
Yeah, it's broken the gap a little bit front to the front as we see Kendrick Louie come up the beach, but also his brother Shannon has caught up on him a little bit. Ali Day, Matt Poole, Kane Eckstein. This is after the ski. Shannon Eckstein and Matt Bevilacqua. Then we have Kendrick Louie, Wes Berg, Kai Hurst, Nathan Smith and Jackson Maynard.
Well, it's absolutely blowing my mind at how fast these two guys are out in front. They're stretched this field out so big. I haven't seen a field stretched out this big in so long.
As we see Wes grinding his way through the sand, and out in front are the guys of Ali Day, Matt Poole, Shannon Eckstein. Here's Kai Hurst deep in the field.
And he predicted right at the start of the day it was going to be a hard day for him. As they're coming back in here to the turnaround point of the board, and Ali Day seems to be doing all the hard work here. He wants to win this round. He wants to win the series. Make no mistake, this is their whole year at play right here. We've only got two rounds when we count this point score and our next round here at Newcastle Beach to decide who the series champion. This is their life, and Ali Day is doing all the right things right now.
And here comes Pooley down on the wave. Oh. He just waited, didn't he? And there was a gap forming. They'll be right next to each other when they run up onto the beach here. This is Ali Day. This is Matt Poole, the training partners. Who's going to win round five in Newcastle?
Reese, is he a little nervous, Ali? He's making little mistakes. He just had the chance to really get away then he kind of stumbled and picked up his board. Is he getting a little nervous?
Yeah, you'd think so, Trevor. There's a lot of pressure on it on the guy, but there's Kane Eckstein. He's not out of it yet, but look, Shannon Eckstein. He's clawing his way back into it. He wants to get on the podium. He's thinking points for the overall series. He can't let Ali Day jump too far in front of him.
He slowed right up, Kane Eckstein, not running anywhere near as quick as he was before. And here comes Shannon. Wouldn't be surprised if he gets him shortly.
This is Ali Day pushing the pace. Shannon's still chasing. He'll be looking for, I don't think he can get first or second now. He'll be looking for third to overtake his brother. But Ali Day has gone out again as we see Shannon pop over. a master at all things Ironman, particularly the skills area and the transitions. Not quite on the pace of these guys today. Ali laying down there out in front. This is incredible.
Yeah, it's crucial if he does get third as well, because everything's more points.
Here's Pooley leading around the last can. They're going to turn away. You want to try and get on that first runner. Get first crack of it. Pooley needs to lift his rate.
He's away. He's got a tiny little break.
He does. Here he goes. But Ali Day, look at that rate of Ali's. He's going to get on this little runner. And
hey, Ali up on the knees there. So it's Matt Poole, Ali Day. Ali Day leading the series. Matt Poole in fourth place. But remember, the thing that went to Western Australia for him was that seaweed that stopped him. But Matt Poole desperate to get on the podium, get to the top of the podium.
Ali on this. Look at his rate. He's trying to get the jump on Pooley. He's pushing for it here.
He's heading south. It's a gamble. If he can get this run and get up to the south, he could have this. He's
Ali Day.
He's going to get it. I think he's going to get this little run. Oh, no.
Too early. Oh, no, too early. That's the nervousness. Something's going on. Come on, Ali. He's got to run through the rocks. Here's Matt Pooley. The big finisher, Matt Poole.
Now, Ali Day's out wide. He's made that mistake. Matt Poole, look at him grinding and punching his way up the sand. He won here in Newcastle last year. He's going to get to the can first, Matt Poole. Ali trying, busting. He's hurting all over. Today's the pool day, not Ali's day. Well done, Matt. Absolutely outstanding there. Ali extraordinary as well. He shakes his head, disappointed that he got up early. And here is Shannon and Kane down on the same wave.
Third.
Kane's rolled off over on the right. He's over that side. Shannon will hold him off here from this side of the field. Kane runs through the rocks. That's going to set up a huge round six in the point score.
Yeah, Shannon has come through to beat his brother again onto the beach, and he'll come third. Kane will come fourth, and round six, what about that? Mouth-watering. Kane just wanders over the line now after such a great performance. Let's get down to Ashlyn, because Ashlyn is with the winner, and he was so, so pleased when he crossed the line, wasn't he, Matt Poole? A great effort by him, winning round five. Ashlyn?
Congratulations, Matt. Well done. What a finish.
Oh, my God. That hurt so bad. Ali skipped away early, and it was like a replay of round three where Shannon did it. And I was with Kane, and we're just trying to edge him back slowly, and I pulled up in one swim leg, and look, he pushed me so hard. It's hot, it was flat. When we came down that wave and the sprint finished, honestly didn't know if my legs were going to hold out, but I got there, so I'm wrapped.
It did come down to the sprint finish. You just hit the ground running though.
Yeah, look, I thought Ali right at the end was going to pull over that little wave, and I was like, no, I've lost it again, but it just sort of died out a little bit, and I got down this little bump. He got up before me and I just ran. I was hoping those long legs were going to pull me through, so paid off.
Yeah, it certainly did. Congratulations, Matt Poole, on the win.
Thank you.
So Matt Poole, pretty happy those long legs did do it for him. Kendrick Louie is good, mate. And this is the way it ended up. Round five of the Nutri-Grain Ironman Series. Matt Poole, a winner in Newcastle again. Then Ali Day, Shannon Eckstein, Kane Eckstein, Matt Bevilacqua, Kendrick Louie, Wesberg, Kaihurst, Smith, Maynard, Cuff, Tannen Linden in 12th, 13th Jack Moy, Sammy Ham, and Hayden Allam. Back to you, Ashlyn.
So for the first time this series, Matt Poole is on top of the podium. Congratulations, Matt. He looks very happy to be there, and so he should be. Ali Day and Shannon Eckstein are beside him. Reese, what a race. I really feel for Ali Day. For so long there, it looked like he could do no wrong, but as we know, anything can happen.
Well, that was awesome to watch that race. I thought Ali Day was going to run away with it. He kept turning the can, linking up these awesome waves all the way to the beach. He kept increasing his lead until Pooley decided to try and work his way back into the race. And each leg, he slowly chipped away at that lead, and eventually he got neck and neck with Ali Day in that last board leg, put a little bit of pressure on him and come away with a magnificent victory. That was awesome for Pooley. That was massive for him this season. So that was so good to watch.
And one thing's for sure, it certainly keeps things interesting as we head into the final round. So let's have a look at the series points ladder, where they stand after five rounds. Ali Day still in front. He now has a four-point lead on Shannon Eckstein, who's there in second place on 79 points. Matt Poole moves up to third position. Kaihurst in fourth. Kendrick Louie not too far behind. Wesberg still hanging in there, as is Jack Moyes, Luke Cuff.
And over the page, this is where it gets really interesting for those automatic qualifiers for next year. Matt Bevilacqua, Tannen Linden, Nathan Smith, Kane Eckstein, they're all so close on the points, just trying to get into that top eight for next year. As we look down, we see Jackson Maynard, Hayden Allen, and Sam Hamilton just hanging in there in 15th.
And of course, earlier today, we saw the Iron Women race, and we saw just another brilliant performance by Liz Plumas. She is just unstoppable this year.
Yeah, she's just been awesome. She's the total professional, awesome to watch. She is on fire. Great race.
Yeah, it's going to take a lot to beat her at this point. So let's have a look at the women's series points where they stand after five rounds, heading into the final one. Liz Plumas ahead by 13 points. Rebecca Creedy there in second. Harriet Brown coming in at third on 73. Jordan Mercer still in fourth position. Courtney Hancock, the defending champ, and Maddie Dunn still on equal fifth. Brodie Moyer and Emma Dick still hanging in there in the top eight. They had brilliant races today.
Over the page, we're looking at Crystal Smith, the veteran. She's into ninth now, so she's not too far away from Emma Dick for that automatic qualifying position. Then we go back to equal 10th, Tara Coleman, Amy Nerthen. They'll battle it out in the final round to see who can jump in ahead of one another. And then we look down at Devon Halligan in 14th, and rounding out the girls is Hannah Minogue.
So that wraps up round five of the Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Ironman and Women's Series. It was an awesome day of racing. And now it all comes down to round six, the final round. It'll be here at Newcastle Beach, and it's an eliminator, one of the most exciting events to watch because it is sudden death racing. I can't wait. You can watch all the action at home right here on Channel 9 next Sunday. But for now, I'm Ashlyn Krukellis on behalf of myself, Rhys Drury, and the rest of the team. See you later.